It was like, if I come in here and slack all day, I ain't gonna grow as a fighter. You know what I'm saying? I come in here, put time in. You know, people use their kids as an excuse. I use my kids as motivation. I come in here, I fight for my kids. Like I said, I'm providing for two kids and a family. Like, I come in here, my son isn't here now. You know, there is no, oh, I got kids, I can't train. I'm gonna come in here, he gonna train right with me. My work ethic, man, above that, when I come in, I put in crazy work. There's no stopping me. There's nothing I can't learn, so there's nothing I wouldn't try. This ring, this very ring right here, man. Oh, man, this is the first time. In this ring, I got my first bloody nose. I got my first black eye in this ring. First time I dropped somebody was in this ring. First time I broke somebody's rib was in this ring. First time I announced to my team that I was having a baby was in this ring. If it was better circumstances, my baby shower would have been in this gym. You know what I'm saying? This is home to me. I take care of it. You see, you got my little brothers, Onyx over here. Coach, one of my coaches, he's also a professional boxer, Eddie. You know what I'm saying? We got an upcoming female fighter, Marie, over there. So what's up, Marie? You know, we got the parents, we got the family, we got everybody. One of our trainers, Coach Paul. Coach Paul is amazing. My bro, Alejandro. No, this is actually the bathroom. We call it the sauna room because this is the only place that got heat. Like, just get hot because we work out, but this is here, you're sitting here, you're doing the bathroom. Come back here. Oh, this is home. One of my little bros, Junior. This kid dedicated 2 years to the gym. He worked so hard. You know, he's going to be up and coming. He's fighting soon. And this very area here, I broke. And I won't repeat this in front of anybody. I broke 6 punching bags. Hard work, baby. No game. This is all love, man. This is what made me me. It's not a lot to look at, but you get a lot out of it, you know. This is the weight room. I take pride in this specific room only because I myself put this together. We had a lot of equipment. It was looking cluttered. It was looking crazy. I took it upon myself to come in here earlier on a Saturday. I broke machines down, built them back up, sold it, organized, cleaned it, you know, swept it. A couple of guys was in here. We don't need no Planet Fitness. We don't need, you know what I'm saying? We don't need nothing. We need to come in here and work out as a team. Right, baby? Right? Yeah. Give me 5. Beso. Mwah, I love you. If y'all don't know me, I'm John DeWilliams. Boxing ain't call me the boss. You call me everything. I'm the boss. I'm Showtime, Showbiz, Mr. Uppercut, whatever you want to call me, as long as it's positive. At the end of the day, I pride myself on being humble. My amateur record wasn't bad, 13-0, 5 knockouts. Nobody count knockouts, though. like I said, I'm June 6th, I'm making my pro debut. I guess I'm a guy from Jersey. Honestly, no matter who it is, at the end of the day, I work too hard. My record as an amateur, man, I was known. A lot of my best, I would say, competitions was sparring, because I got a strong team behind me. You know, I got from my little brother that's four years in a row building a champion, Martino Jules. He's 15 years old, he's nice, you know what I'm saying? I get work with him. My little bro, Tyrone, a number one in the nation. At his weight class, I got my big brother, Jerome Rodriguez. He coming here, he's southpaw, 3-0 as a pro. We got Ronald Cruz from Bethel, he definitely champion right now. We got Ricky Nuno, he's a professional MMA fighter. Scott Smith, he's a champion. I believe at 132. In MMA, so we got a healthy team. A lot of my great sparring, you know, all my great fights, I would say, came from training with my brothers. Like, competition is regular, you know, this amateur competition level. A lot of my team is ready for that. You know, I got my other brothers that's coming up. We got Eric, we got Tyrese, we got Randy. So many more to come. We got a healthy team behind us. And as far as my records, I give it to them. You know, some of my worst days, some of my best days was sparring right in my gym. I got a lot of kids looking up to me, you know what I'm saying? I'm leading by example. I'm walking on eggshells, you know, making sure I don't mess up so that, it's not leverage for somebody else to be like, oh, you know what I'm saying? You messed up, I can mess up too, you know? I graduated high school on the road. I'm in college right now, studying to be a medical assistant. I'm a professional boxer. I'm living my life, working on, you know what I mean? I motivate myself, man, but beyond me, you know, beyond being selfish, staying humble. I fight for my family, I fight for my town. You know, born and raised in the Bronx, but, you know, moved out here to Allentown. Allentown been good to me, so I made it get back. Our gym is located 402 Ridge Avenue. Right up the block from Second Street. We in the middle, we in the heart of Allentown at the end of the day. We in the area that's not, you know what I'm saying? not so beneficial, but at the end of the day, we bring light to this, you know, we bring light to the neighborhood. When we step out these doors, we don't fear for our life, because at the end, it's all love. You know what I'm saying? We walk out the door. We don't walk out the doors dodging bullets only because we're a positive place. So our goal, you know what I mean, as role models, no matter how old we are, we're more models to other kids our age, you know what I'm saying? So if we come to this town, we come to this part of the neighborhood, do good, you know, be positive, we motivate a lot of people to be positive too. My biggest thing to any fighter coming up, man, stay humble. You know what I'm saying? Stay humble, stay humble, stay humble. You know what I'm saying? When it comes down to it, when you're down to your last dollar, when you have nothing, when you broke after being rich, you know, if you was always humble, true to your word, and sincere, people are gonna remember that. So if you're on top humble, when you fall to the bottom, people are gonna remember you for being humble and they're gonna bless you. So my advice to little kids, just stay humble. Jonathan Williams, aka The Boss, June 6th, Showtime.